The following video is an educational video. I am not responsible for any damage done on your end. Always read all instructions carefully. Safety is always top priority.
Alright, got my thermal paste in, and I'm going to unbox it, I guess. Okie dokie. Use this knife. Let's see what's inside. And here it is. $7. $7 for this. And it's about $10 at Radio Shack, but this is from Amazon. It's way cheaper to order stuff online. Here it is. It's 3.5 grams. Come on, focus. Da-da-da, there we go. High density. Alright, there goes the unboxing. And there should be nothing else in there. It's empty. Alright.
If you're like me and you didn't purchase ArtiClean, you can use isopropyl alcohol or rubbing alcohol, and if possible, use a 90% grade or better just for safety measures. You will also need a lint-free cloth like a coffee filter or Q-tips to clean off the older thermal paste. Look at this OEM crap Dell put on my Inspiron 1545. It's like dried compressed chalk. My sister's Dell Inspiron 1545 has this problem too. Just look at it. These three pictures were taken 3 months after I got this laptop. Now, back to cleaning the old thermal paste. Fortunately, I happened to find a 2-in-1 solution. You can use these Zeiss lens wipes. A pack of 50 will cost around $3 in Walmart, which is about $4 cheaper than ArtiClean. You can either find these Zeiss lens wipes at Walmart or inside of Walmart's Vision Center. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and open up my favorite web browser. Mine happens to be Firefox. Click on that. It's going to load on Google. I'm going to type in Arctic Silver. Hit enter. Here's the main website, arcticsilver.com. It's a second link. And then here's the main website. On the fourth tab over, you'll find instructions. Click on that. And then choose the product you're trying to install in your processor and your heatsink. Mine is Arctic Silver 5. And then I have an Intel platform. Click on that. And then find your processor right here. It's very, very similar to AMD. I happen to have a Pentium dual core processor, but this is not the right one. There's a catch. You'll see. My computer has two physical cores, but one virtual core. This dual core processor means like two virtual cores. So I'm gonna go back and choose single core, even though my computer is actually two physical core processor. But it's one virtual core shown here. But there's a catch. All these right here, all these methods are for desktop processors with IHSs or integrated heat spreaders. You don't know what that is. It's a metal cap on top of the processor. My laptop doesn't have that, so this is pretty much useless to me, so I'm gonna go ahead and close that out. And you have to spread the whole processor with the thermal compound. Alright, let's go ahead and get started. Look at that, it's dried up. Focus here, come on. That should be better. Oh well, you get the point, it's dried up. Oh, it wants to focus after I put it away. Look at that stuff, it's dried up, it won't come off. Alright, put this right here. And then, look at this. To be honest, this heat
pad or thermal pad is crap, but I'd rather be using this instead of this dried up shit. Go ahead and take this off. This is gonna be a while. Thank you.
These are comparisons before and after applying Arctic Silver 5 in the following order, before and after. The room temperature before Arctic Silver 5 was 71.7 degrees. The room temperature after Arctic Silver 5 was 69.7 degrees, so I'll be adding 2 degrees to every after value. The low, high, and idle temperatures are not accurate because I have no control over the fan speed, so just look at the raw data. 2 minutes of idle before Arctic Silver 5, the cores average 123 degrees. 2 minutes of idle after Arctic Silver 5, the cores average 121 degrees, but once again, the room temperature was 2 degrees cooler. So I'm going to add 2 degrees, so it's 123 degrees. So there's no change from before and after. Again, these are not accurate. The next one counts. This is 1 minute into HTML website, the wilderness downtown. Before, it averaged 128.5 degrees. This is the same website. The cores average 116.5 degrees, but once again, add 2 degrees because of the room temperature difference, so it's 118.5, 10 degrees cooler. And this is 7 minutes of folding at home. The cores average 138 degrees, as you can see. This was with the viewer open, so it stressed out CPU and GPU. And this was 7 minutes after, and the cores average 125 degrees. Once again, add 2 degrees, so it's 127 degrees. That's 11 degrees cooler. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe. This video is brought to you by PRT1667. He bought me this Arctic Silver 5 thermal paste as a gift. Check out his YouTube channel and subscribe.